This evening, I have an audience with 23 newly minted Eagle Scouts. What do I want to say to these fine young men? Well, tonight, I want to give you encouragement and talk about possibility. I'm sitting in front of 23 high achievers. Why would I think that encouragement is the first thing that I need to talk to them about? They're obviously doing quite well. Well, the reason I want to give you encouragement is because you're going to need it. With talents and abilities you've been given come great responsibility. The responsibility to use your talents to their greatest and highest use in this, your one life. I used to think that I was responsible for my achievements because of my hard work. Well, that's true. But I've come to understand that there was something put in me by my Creator that makes me work hard, that makes me go for more, that makes me disciplined, that makes me go that much more and that much more again. This I had no part in. When I was born, it was done. And now I have to live with it and carry my talents to their full blossom. And you do too. Because you're a different kind of person, a high achiever, you will never be happy with anything but high achievement. And because of this, you will need as much encouragement as anyone else. You have higher talent and ambitions, but you'll be playing a higher game, which means it'll be difficult and challenging. And that's how it should be. For Eagle Scouts, if your life is easy, you're probably wasting it. Feeling as though it's a struggle at times is part of the work you've been called to do. But we're not made to struggle forever. It's part of learning. The world is sending you feedback that you need to change something to get the results you say you want. Listen to that feedback and keep developing yourself. Because your world will not change or get better until you do. But then you go for more, you stretch yourself farther still. This I know about you. And that will require a new you. You'll have to learn more and grow personally yet again. The years will pass and your contributions to the world will add up. But you'll still look for even greater levels of contributions because that's who you are. You're an Eagle Scout. So I put an ad in the paper, in the classified section, in the newspaper. And yes, this is before the internet days. This was 1982. Carpentry, call Larry. No job too small. And I showed up on time. I followed through, and I got lots of work. And every time somebody wanted me to do something, the situation was always the same for a long time. I had never done it before. I didn't know how to do it. But I knew that I could find out. So here's the lesson. If anyone can do it, then anyone can do it. I felt that if another guy could do the job, well, he was no better or smarter than I was, and I could do it too. All I had to do was find out how to do it. When I was in scouting, I had 56 merit badges. And each time I started a merit badge, I'd read the requirements, and I'd have no knowledge of the subject at first. But I believe scouting taught me that I could learn, that I could find out, and not to be afraid of new things. Scouting expanded my horizons dramatically. When I grew up on the second floor of a three-family house in Bridgeport, my world was about as far as I could ride my bike and back. Scouting took me places I'd have never been. I learned about a lot of things that I love. It was the education that was missing in my public school. I became a three-dimensional person in scouting. My calling thus far in life has been business. I'm a big fan of business. Why? Because businesses create and deliver all the products and services that make people's lives better. People will only buy what I have to offer, giving me their hard-earned money in a voluntary exchange, if they feel that their life will be better, if they feel that what I have is worth more than the money to them. The secret of success is that your rewards in life will be in direct proportion to the degree that you help others. And businesses have to help others or they die. In the process, I've created thousands of jobs and paid lots of the various taxes that are used for infrastructure, the common defense, and lots of other things that shouldn't be used for. I want to tell you that your character means far more than your knowledge. A scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Live by this. It's important. I've made mistakes, and you will too. You'll do things you're not proud of. You're human. But you must learn from your mistakes and not repeat them. I've also learned to be nice to people. I've had many opportunities open up to me because people liked me or trusted me. Be nice, even if the other person is a jerk and deserves a dressing down. Go easy. People may not remember what you said, but they'll always remember the way you made them feel. I've also learned to ask the right questions, simple questions like, why are we doing this? And why not me? And what is the cause of this? And what did that person do to get those results? Because I want to do that too. Keep asking questions. And I've learned that just because something, an idea or an attitude is popular, doesn't make it right. Don't be a spectator in life. Get involved. Be a leader. Grow strong in every way so you can help others. Because you can't help others if you need help yourself. So I want to wrap up my time telling the Eagle Scouts here, and everyone here, that my philosophy is that anything is possible for you. Anything. But you have to choose what to pursue. And you have to do the work. Because you can do anything, but you can't do everything. In this choosing, follow your heart. You know, we're all different. Thank God. And what you were put here for lies in your desires. If you don't want something, it's not possible for you. So follow what you really want. Because when you do that, it doesn't seem like work, and you'll enjoy your life. And don't follow the crowd unless you want to be normal. But as I have already established, you aren't. I recognize this award I have been given tonight is a high honor, and I'm grateful for it. And I pledge that whatever I've done to deserve it, I will continue doing on my honor. Thank you.